Ready, guys? In 3, 2, 1, go! Squat cleans, box jumps, thrusters, burpees over bar, sumo deadlift high pull, double unders.
My name's Andy Osborne. I'm from Leicester, and I started up the CrossFit about 2 years ago. I've been into fitness for about the last 15 years, always been into functional training, and CrossFit just kept popping up through the research that I used to do. And so I thought, well, I need to find out what's going on here. So went over to Miami, met Josh, and he let me join in on his WOD. When I came back from that, I was all stoked up. So just had to get on the level one and all start from there. I was going on holiday anyways. I thought, you know, what better to do than just go and visit a CrossFit box in America.
Basically, we got 15 minutes to do as many as we can. 15, knees to elbow, and 5. Handstand push-ups.
That's hard work, I'm telling you. Serious hard work. I need to train more, I'm telling you.
I try and keep myself as educated as possible, try and keep on top of the stuff. And I've been to Coach Bergner's Olympic lifting workshops, and one of the things she drilled into us was the Bergner warm-up. And I find that that's very effective. Whether we're doing Olympic lifts on that day or not, it's a great thing to implement within the warm-up to help people, you know, develop their Olympic lifting. And as this box is quite a new box, as far as we have a lot of people that have not been doing CrossFit for less than a year. So it's good to get them into the habit of the different elements of the Olympic lift.
It's very Coach Bergner having the class yield back to you. That's very
it is. It's a blueprint of that. Everything is his. It's not mine. I'm not taking credit for that at all. It's his warm up. I shout out the move, and they shout back why they're doing the move.
So
down and up is for speed through the middle.
Down and up!
Speed
down
and
up!
And then?
So elbows high and on the outside. I've cut that down because it's a bit of a mouthful, so I just put elbows high, and they reply, keep the bar close.
Elbows high!
Keep the bar close!
Elbows high!
Keep the bar close!
Then the next part is the snatch.
Snatch!
Turnover!
Snatch!
Turnover!
And then you have the footwork dropping down to different depths.
2, 4, 6.
Oh yeah, it's good. I mean, it's good. It's a bit of participation from them as well, so that they're, you know, they're on the ball and, you know, keep them awake.
I like that.
My name's Jennifer, and I co-own CrossFit Leicester. And I'm very proud to co-own CrossFit Leicester.
Tell me about that. I can tell that you're proud. I can tell you are. To your husband's words, you're a CrossFit geek.
I am a CrossFit geek. I know, that's really bad. And I really apologize for Saturday night, because I kept on saying Greg says. But I really do believe, I love Greg's philosophy of how he started everything. I love the fact that he goes on about focusing on the community and not focusing on selling shoes or selling kit or anything else, and focus on the people that are here and the training and making sure the quality of training is consistent throughout. I love that. Strong women. I love that as a slight old-fashioned feminist. I love that this sport gives women an equal stand to men, and our women are lifting more than most of the men, and I love it that the men feel intimidated by some of our women. I love it. I think that's absolutely amazing. I love that our women will challenge ourselves, won't cry, won't just read a book, and it's not all glossy lip gloss and makeup and all that kind of stuff from the Globo gyms. At CrossFit is about real women, about real energy, about their passion to do it, push their boundaries, We've had women that have had alcohol problems, that CrossFit's helped them get through that, marriage problems, and our community has helped them get through that. That is what CrossFit is about. It's not just about the training modality, it's about pushing you mentally as well to take you to a stronger place, and I think that's absolutely fantastic.
How old are you?
How old am I? Should you be asking a lady her age?
Yeah, but I think it's impressive.
I'm 53.
53 to be doing pull-ups. That's something to be proud of.
I am proud. Tell her. She's the only person that doubts herself. She's the same as everybody else, you see.
So are you saying you didn't always realise that that's something to be proud of?
No.
Why not?
Because I expect to be the same as everybody else, irrelevant of your age.
I sense she doesn't have the full gravitas of just how awesome it is to be able to, like, say, RX Fran is 53 years old. What, are you tearing up?
No, no.
I see tears.
I'm camera shy.
The camera shy, not showing any other way, though.
So you've done personal training outside of CrossFit, so you've been around trying to coach people outside of the world CrossFit. Take away CrossFitting people, CrossFitters. How many women in her age category could RX Fran on the earth? What percent?
Probably about 1%, if that.
No, I know. People say to me, oh, as a co-box owner, you don't do the actual WODs. And I go, no, I can't. I literally physically would damage myself at this present point, but I do one-to-one training over in the strength and conditioning area. CrossFit for the core essence of what CrossFit is. And the core essence of CrossFit is every single person, doesn't matter what you do, is important within the CrossFit community.
And where are you from?
I'm from Coventry originally, but I live in Leicester now.
And how did you get into CrossFit?
Well, me and my girlfriend saw a video on YouTube of a girl from CrossFit Bergen doing some heavy lifting. And then on the right hand side was the Killing the Fat Man documentary. So we watched that through episode after episode, all back to back, and decided that we wanted to do CrossFit. Had a look for the local box and realised there was actually one in Leicester, so I joined up, and then when my girlfriend moved here, she came straight along and did it, because originally she wasn't going to start CrossFit, because all the videos on the internet were all really good people and she didn't think she could, so it's a case of we watched the video and realised it looked so much fun that we'd give it a go.
So,
and then we've been here since.
It helped seeing a fat guy.
Well, I think it was just the progression and how excited you got every episode as you got more and more into it and learnt more and more things, and we decided that we wanted to do that.
And how's it going? Did I let you down?
No, not at all. I mean, we're here still, and I've been here for nearly a year now, and come every day. Absolutely love it.
You too, you've stuck with it?
Love it, absolutely love it. It gives me a reason to get up in the morning. The alarm goes off at 10:05 in the morning, and just stoked to come down and train, and the atmosphere down here is just so
much. So you weren't
fun
here for the WOD this morning, but you heard, and so you came running down.
Yeah.
Awesome, cool, great meeting you.
You too, thank you.
Pleasure to meet you, brother.
Yeah, you too.
All right.
Thank you for the videos.
Thank you.
These people are my family. People don't realise I care about them. I care about them afterwards. I write to them, I email them. I say, why haven't you come? And they go, oh my God, a Globo gym would never do that to me. And that is, to me, what Greg Stutt said. It is about caring for everyone from the beginning.
Drug dealers were shooting at the police through the windows, and unfortunately we couldn't afford to spend the money to replace all the windows, so we've had to put mirrors in some of the glass areas.
Sorry, before this was CrossFit, this was what?
A cannabis factory. A cannabis factory.
Did you have members that did what?
And raided this building.
Police officers.
The police officers that raided this building. Yeah, and I don't want people being put off, but it's just where we could afford to be. And I think if you've got the desire to set up a CrossFit gym, you start off anywhere, and the community will come with you, and that's what it's all about.